Hello, everybody. They call me Muse. And stop checking that gun, 47. You don't need that gun. It's the Bare Knuckle Boxer Challenge, where it's naught but our camera. And we're going to take time trial for our next prestige, because that's the only one we might be able to do. Now, where might we be going for a time trial? Whit Creek seems sensible, because it's a small map, don't you know? No combat. Take no damage. Don't blow your disguise. So everything on Whit Creek basically says silent assassin this, if at all possible. Except for time trial, which says no, you're gonna die. Now, Miami, it's alerted. One of the problems with alerted is loads of cameras. Miami's got the easiest cameras in the world to get rid of. No witnesses, hide target, but again, it's basically saying silent assassin this stuff. I mean, I don't like the idea of doing any of these time trial, to be honest. Maybe we go Whit Creek. Just on the basis that we can get a silent submachine gun, and then we can just go for time trial instead of anything else. Maybe. Good Lord, we're gonna just fail this new video 10 minutes in, aren't we? Right, so where are we looking? Janus property basement. That's fine. Wilson property hanging out front. Spencer the Hammer Green. That's ideal, because we were probably going to go for his outfit anyway. Now, Spencer's in there. Yes, we got him. Good. If you get here quick enough, Spencer's in there. And that's just ideal for our purposes. We probably still want to go upstairs, though, to get a silent submachine gun. And to do that, let's see. We would probably want to. Let's just drag this guy out of the way first, because his mate might come in a minute just because the generator's still running. So, there goes Spencer. Yeah, here comes his mate. So, can we get an outfit nice and quick? Pick up this shotgun before Matey Boy sees it. And we've still got the car battery in hand. Whoa, that was close. Right, so you turn that one off
Gotta
for me.
conserve that energy.
Yeah. Have a nap, friend. Now, we don't need to hide this guy in a cupboard or a fridge. But I'm going to anyway, just because it's practically muscle memory at this point. Right. So, I want to move upstairs at this point. I want to take out the cameras and then move upstairs. Because there's chaps upstairs who have guns which I could use. We don't need to worry about hiding bodies at least. Now, you've got a gun I could use, as have you. And you're going into that room. So let's just knock you out. Grab ourselves the silent subby. And go and find target number two. Who is hopefully not far away. There they are. Now, how do we deal with them without getting spotted or anything like that? I think we grab the key, we open this door, and then we do that. Yeah, that seems to have worked out okay. Our supply is underneath us, but I'm not worried about that for now. Because now we want to head to the basement of this building. So, how do we do that without getting spotted by these garbage men? Do we have to go round? It's probably safest to go round. I don't know if there's a way to cut in front of them without being spotted, so we'll vault over here. And up. Oh, no combat's gone. I guess someone saw us shoot that woman and got a bit agitated. Which is understandable. But honestly, no combat is like the hardest thing to get in the game, it seems. Okay, we haven't got any way into this door. Or have we? Hansen's house key, is that necessary? Seems like it won't let us into this door. But again, old school lockpick will do the job. Now, Janice bodyguard. May as well. And we can pop this open. And is our target the only man down here? Turns out we're trespassing either way. Well, we're enforced either way by this lad. But that's fine. Down he goes. Chuck him in a cupboard just in case someone else comes down. Why not? So yeah, time trial was always going to get in the way of bloody no combat. Sadly. But now that we're done, we can pop back and see our supplier. Do we even need to pop back and see our supplier? Are they going to have anything of use for us? I'm going to say no, just because we've got no money, really. What have we got here? But can it hurt to pop back? And yeah, nothing except freelancer tools, which I don't really need right now. 3 out of 4, including time trial. We will definitely take it. Right, so now we're looking at Miami, because we don't want to do an alerted Miami for our showdown, if we can possibly avoid it. What we got? Oh, we finally got the lockpick back. That's spiffing. So, we could do Silent Assassin. We could, though, do Timed Hide and Seek. We're going to need crates anyway, but there are wide expanses of Miami where we might have difficulty finding crates. But Silent Assassin can be broken so easily. And if we do end up with witnesses, we're going to murk them. So maybe Timed Hide and Seek is our best bet. But let's go see what Miami has to offer today. It's got dolphins. Blurry newspapers. Right, cameras first, yes. So we've got Patricia, who's right by the exit by the look of it, which is curious. We've got Tyler, who's in the Kronstadt area. Oh, he's in the Android room. Very well. We've got Oscar, who's a medic, it seems. And we've got Larry, who's either a jogger or a security guard, probably. So what do we want outfit-wise? Security outfit's generally pretty strong. Even if it's going to be seen through by all of our targets on this alerted map. But then there's lots of places we're going where we'll just be public, so maybe we don't need it. Either way, let's get these cameras sorted. Whoop. Cut that a little fine. Now, it's probably a better outfit for me than regular. There's going to be a few spots where there'll be enforcers, but even then, let's take security. But then maybe.
I lost him in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there.
Maybe we also take Flamingo. Now. Do we need to worry about this guy? I don't think so. It doesn't really matter if anyone finds that bot. Now let's go and have a look at this woman who is near the entrance. See what might be done about her. Oh shit, hide and seek. I've almost blown it already. There's a bin back here, isn't there? Now I can hear the ticking. Counting down to our potential doom. Phew. We've made it. We're in a dumpster full of trash. Now let's go and see about this Patricia woman, if we can. Maybe we also pop in here. Is there like a lead pipe or something lying around? There it is, good. Never know when that will come in handy. Also, how are we not trespassing in here? I'm sure this is trespassing in suit. So why is it not trespassing when you're a flamingo? I guess we're an employee. We've got some privileges. It's probably a coin in that guy's thing. Let's grab a crowbar. Yeah, that guy's got a coin and a didgeridoo. Let's take that as well. Now, maybe, whilst I've got a crowbar, we are going to want to crack this gate open, I think, to get into the expo center at some point. And there's also a dumpster over here, so we can reset our clock once again. Right, now where's she gone? Has she moved? She only bloody moved. She's over there now. Bloody hell, that'll teach me for not paying even the slightest shred of attention to my targets. Now, we are allowed in here, yes?
Hi there! Welcome!
A grown man.
Let me just repeat some ground. I'm a grown-ass man disguised as a flamingo.
How can a grown man degrade himself like that? I mean, look at that costume!
Jeez. Everyone judging me today. That's Pam.
Okay, ready when you are.
Good. Whoa.
Oh.
Yep.
Thanks.
Take that. Now, that door's locked. Is there a crate up here somewhere? And are we trespassing? Believe it or not, I don't use this outfit a lot. And I'm unsure as to where we can go and what we can do. Don't mind me, friends. Now, there might be a crate in the security room across here somewhere. I hope so. Otherwise, we're running out of time to find one. Yeah, that door's locked. Of course it is. Everything's bloody locked on alerted.
I'm sorry. This area's closed.
My bad. That door's open. It's not really much help though. Yeah, there's nowhere up here where we can hide. Fig. Down in the pit area though. Is there a bin? No, it's on the other side. We haven't got time. Is there a locker? Woo! We're cutting it tight on these here hides. Take that card in case we need it later. Oh, we're trespassing down here, though. What if we became the Pale Rider? Maybe that would help. Maybe we drop our didgeridoo for a quick selfie. Well, these mirrors are ass. Yeah, those mirrors are filthy. I guess we'll have to find another one somewhere. Is that a mechanic's outfit? Yeah, Kowloon mechanic. Is that more or less useful than the Pale Rider? I feel like the Pale Rider doesn't really let you go anywhere. But now that we've taken a screenshot of it for the thumbnail, we are kind of using it. Alright, there's our target. They're a medic.
Whoa.
What was that, friend? You should come and investigate. Now that you're here, maybe you should investigate further. Yep, you heard that.
Dispatch. I just heard something fishy.
What do you mean dispatch? You're a medic. Now, can we... Where is she? She's not looking in our direction. Good. Come with me, friend. We are going to go and find a bin. And then we're both going to climb in it. Because I wouldn't do to you what I wouldn't do to me. Although, is there a bin in this direction? And are there any locked doors in the way? No, there's no locked door here. Good. That door is locked, though. Yeah. There's a bin there, but that door's locked. Is there a bin down here? Yeah. There's a baseball bat, too. And what looks like a couple of joggers over there. So I guess joggers are our last two targets over there. So I guess now it's time for a big old drag. In the bin with you, my friend. And in the bin with us, too. Now, I'm guessing Medic and Pale Rider are both equally useful slash useless as outfits for us right now. So this baseball bat's illegal to carry, yeah? Yeah, that's illegal. Shovel, on the other hand, not illegal. Same job, same size, more legal. Let's bring our trusty shovel with us on our adventures. So no combat, no witnesses. So again, bodies want to be hidden in general. Now, I think we want to go up and across. We're not trespassing again. Just used a bin, but even so. Let's use another. And what have we got? A couple of marshals. They don't seem to mind us here. So this would be trespassing. If we were in our suit. But Pale Rider is allowed here. That's kind of useful. Right. Flamingo's finally been found. But nobody really cares because, well, nobody was witness. And no combat is happening. Because nobody saw him fall. So I guess if no one sees you fall, combat doesn't occur. So only if they see you fall and they're a guard, or they then get called to the scene. But now, is there a crate in here that I missed? No. Huh. This guy could be trouble. You know what we do to troublemakers around here? We shovel them. And then we bob back up to our trusty box. Is there a box in the boat shed? Can we even get in the boat shed? Because we don't have a key for it. Maybe the reason Flamingo didn't cause chaos is because he was found by a civilian rather than a guard. And if a guard had found him, then we would have had problems. I'm not 100% on the rules of no combat, still. Now, is anyone watching us? Right, you can't quite be pushed anyway, because you're a little too close.
What?
Don't you worry about that.
We'll be back in a minute.
Okay, okay, just yep. Do your thing, sir.
Yep, you let him do his thing. And in he goes. Now, don't you worry yourself, friend. I will kill everyone if I have to make sure there were no witnesses. Nope, he's pretty chill. I guess he didn't see that gun. Now, one of our targets is here. Good. What if we were to throw this here? Is he gonna... is he gonna come in and around?
The hell
was that? He is. I mean, of course that means he's gonna run into security guard. Right, but let's him out of the way. Now, running out of time again on the old box. which we have cut fine so many times. And sadly, I think we are going to have to deal with this marshal because otherwise, how do we get our friend up here into that box? This guy we probably don't need to deal with, but we're doing it anyway. He could be hidden in the same way, and then we'll bring Jogger up and box him. Question is second Jogger going to make her way over here as well? I'm glad we found a relatively straightforward way to deal with this lab though, because these joggers can be a pain in the butt sometimes. Can't they, Luna? Ow! Ah, jeez. Ah. She clawed me. I'm fine. She does that all the time. She doesn't recognise the difference between me wearing a thick, heavy jumper and just wearing a t-shirt. So she's just like, I'll just dig my claws in, get some purchase, and I'll jump up on the back of your chair. Now, I don't think we need to, but we'll just tuck this lad a bit more out of sight. Employees only behind this point. You're an employee. You can go behind here. Okay, we haven't really helped anything with that. That's fine. Let's go and see if we can't find jogger number two. Maybe she goes close enough to the Ted Mendez area that we can lure her into that little room over there. Let's see. If we can get near the ocean's edge, then obviously we can just chuck her in the ocean. But where else is she going to go? This bit's relatively clear of people. Are you going to come around here, madam? Yes, yeah, she is. Can we get away with this? Yeah, we can. Swish. And that leaves a target in the android room. So we go back to where we cracked open a door some time ago. We may well have to say goodbye to the Pale Rider outfit. But it served us well. It served us really well up till now. But now we need to become some sort of boffin, I think. Again, I'm surprised we're not already trespassing. Though, this outfit does have a surprising range to it.
Sir, get out my way.
Yes, sir. I'll get out your way. Now we're trespassing.
Strange.
Right, so that guy heard that. For sure.
I think they're hurt.
Now, you can just get tossed off the edge, I think. You're a witness. We can't have witnesses, as we've established.
Hello? Someone answer, please. I need help. That's someone causing trouble.
Yep, someone is causing trouble, all right. No combat's gone. To the surprise of no one. What gun did he have, anyway? Just a noisy one. Wasn't expecting anyone to even be in there, though. It's like, it's highly unusual for people to be in there. Must just be an alerted thing. But at least now no combat's gone, we can stop worrying about that. Although it is just obvious from my behaviour there, I'd already stopped worrying about no combat. Is anyone gonna hear our sink and take the bait? Seems like the answer's no. Very well. So what if we instead do a bit of this? Someone's gonna hear that for sure. Who have we got? Another security guard. Not ideal. Not what I wanted.
Anyone there? Answer.
But hey, at least it allows us to get around. So yeah, So long, Power Rider. You were very useful. And there goes that chap. Not for long. He's quickly found by the engineer that works down there. But that's fine.
A new gender-neutral fashion brand.
So our target is...
Hello, HR?
Yes, lurking in the Android
lab. Down at the Bayside Center.
Ooh. Mark Farber's here. The Undying is roaming the halls. That might explain why there's a slightly different layout of personnel. Timothy Yudkard. Right, there's our target. What if we close this door? Then we can grab Timothy Yudkard. Does that help us in any way? He's not our target, is he? No, our target's Tyler. Also, can we have a box, please? So maybe our target can be lured into the room behind. There we go, we're in. Does this help us? I mean, it does in general. Ooh. Explodos. Is there a box anywhere nearby? I want to know before I try killing this guy. Oh, there's one. I was going to say, I'm sure there's one somewhere around here. There has to be. Right. Now, you're not the right guy. So you can come with me. I don't know why I didn't just pick up a fire extinguisher and biff him with it, but there you go. Main thing is he's down. Metal cabinet key. Very nice. Probably. Alright, that's got the attention of a few peeps. Including our man.
This is pissing me off.
That's pissing you off. What about this? That must be positively boiling your blood. Now, if you could just join me in here and get crunched, that would just be grand. And if you could pop in the box, then we could hide target bodies. Perfect. That just leaves getting out of here with no witnesses. I think 3 out of 4 is a pretty good job all round. Assuming we finished the job. General Zaydan's intricate plot, which is feeling more and more, which it looks like we will. Maybe we'll even go back to being a Pale Rider just because we can. I'm not sure if we can use the special Pale Rider exit though. On Freelancer, so I'm going to assume that we can't, and we'll just waltz out the front door like any other pleb might do. I'd say we go and get the safe as well, but we are not in the right outfit, we're not in the right area. Let's just go home. Ooh, hello. Would you look at that? It's a pale car of some sort, unlocked in the safe house. And a cube thing from Mendoza, I believe.
If you feel the urge to do a little interior decorating, please do so.
Did I say you could talk, Diana? Now, arranged meeting's the only one of those we might be able to do. Let's drop all these hackles that we've picked up. I suppose we should have a quick look in the old safe house, see what our new things are. Enjoy a bit of jazz. Hopefully it doesn't get us demonetized. Now, this would be our new decoration. We've got eyeballs, of course. We've got a big ball. And we've got a big cube. I think we'll take it. We like cubes. And finally, we've got some new stuff in the gym. We've still got just boxes lying around. So, are we getting more gym stuff, or what? No, it's going to be replacing the sports car, isn't it? Yeah. Definitely have that. That can sit nicely alongside our hit van and our cool chopper. Grand. Might even take that car on the next mission. We've got Dartmoor face. Suitonia, I definitely recall, was one of our challenges. Make target slip. Melee weapon kill. Melee weapon kill, certainly doable. Make target slip, less so, because we're not bringing a banana with us. And it could potentially cause our target to flee when they get woken up by someone. But now, much as I love the hit van, I think it's time to go in style today. Take our new pale vehicle. Oh, that can't deal with these roads. And lovely, it's the garden show. I'm actually hoping it would be this time, because that means suit only should be a bit of a breeze. Getting away without getting spotted could be tricky. But we'll see what we can see. There's a lookout nearby.
I'm the one putting my neck out here.
But we'll grab that wrench.
So not professional.
No. Are we fussed about cameras? No, we don't care. One way or the other. So that's good to know. That'll be another lookout. Do we care about lookouts? As in, do we want to end their lives? Just to make sure that they don't end ours. Now, can we do that anywhere quietly, like?
Huh? What's that? Christ, that had answered my pants. This is not good. Not
Let's
good
see.
At all, man.
Doesn't matter if the bodies are found.
My hands are sweaty. Gross. So,
can we get away with this?
Anyone there? Uh-huh.
Maybe.
See what that was. Let's go.
Okay. All right.
So now someone else is coming over to have a look. And they also could be a lookout. That guy could also be a lookout. What's going on here? Why are there so many potential lookouts around? Now this guy's coming over. Is he a lookout too? He looks like one. Oh, how is he alerted?
Your target is trying to get away.
Fuck off! I choked him out. How is he alerted? Oh, fuck. Now, where is our target? Why is everyone trying to escape? Or is it just this lot? It's just this lot. Target's 209 away from an exit. Is it you? I don't even know who I'm looking for. Glasses, hat, tattoo, grey hair. So it's not you. Good. It's one of these four, I guess. Or that one. But they're 176 from an exit. That one's not trying to escape, really. Someone way over there is trying to escape, though. So it could be them. Shit. Garden's done it to us again. She's got a hat, grey hair, and glasses. It could be her.
Okay, touchdown. But keep your weapons hot.
Right. Okay, it's not them. It is that one who's on the other side of the bloody map. Because those ones are already by an exit.
We can compromise. Don't worry. This is what I'm paid for.
All right then. All right then. Shit.
Right, this has all gone wrong. But it's not necessarily over yet. Because she's still miles away from an exit. Are there any melee weapons around that we can pick up? Doesn't look like it. I cannot believe that choking out that third lookout... Firstly, I can't believe there's three lookouts in a row like that. But secondly... I can't believe any of this, basically. It's all bull.
47, your target is slipping away.
Yeah, she's definitely our target.
How are we doing? Talk to me, people!
Clear and weapons on.
Yeah, we're clear. We're not going to make it, are we? Bollocks. I was right by an exit. I should have just exited.
How unfortunate. It rather appears that you ran out of luck.
Fuck off, Diana. This is why I fired you, mostly.
Back to the drawing board, 47.
God damn it. This is... I'm kicking myself that I didn't just immediately jump on the motorbike and get away. If I'd done that, all would have been well, I guess. We would have got suit only at the very least, so we would have got the challenge complete. Instead, I'm now going to have to come back. Well, I'm now going to have to work my way back up. I mean, yeah, it's not a problem in the one regard, because yay, more Hitman. We like more Hitman. That is what we do. But it's a pain in the ass because I also want to move on to other challenges, you know? So, yeah. I think I'll get back up to the point where I've only got 3 missions left. And then, hopefully, you guys will join me for that next time. And maybe then, finally, we will complete the Bare Knuckle Boxer Challenge. Until then, thanks for watching, friends. I'll see you soon.